Technical test, coding challenges, people agree, people disagree. Today with Andres, we discuss what is the technical test about for TradeMe and what they expect to see in it.
But yeah, we send a tech test, and in that tech test, we kind of expect you to showcase the things that we want in the role. So in software development, there are many ways of solving a problem, and we give you a problem there, and you can solve it in any way that you want. But we hope that the way that you choose is a way that shows that you know the languages that we're hiring for, the frameworks that we use, that you understand what clean code is, that you understand some software patterns. So I'm gonna say something that sounds obvious, but it seems it's not. The first thing that we assess is that the solution actually runs.
It happens a lot.
It's crazy how often
many applications are not running.
Yeah, it's crazy how often we receive something and we try to run it, and it just won't compile or it won't pass the test. So if we're asking you to solve for a calculation of X and it doesn't solve it, then that's a red flag that shows that you weren't paying attention or that that you really didn't dedicate as much time in fixing it as we wanted, or that you didn't even know how to solve the problem, right? So that's kind of one thing. Now, what is clean code? Well, I think in .NET and object-oriented programming, the definition of clean code, it's pretty standard. You want someone that, first of all, you want code that you can read and understand. You don't want to see fancy tricks that are super clever, but it takes you a long time to understand what the code is doing. So okay. The first thing about clean code and the first thing about any developer is that we spend most of our time debugging code rather than writing the code. Writing the code is easy and it's fast. But if you work in any company, you're always gonna find bugs or whatnot, and you'll have to reread it. You'll have to read it years from now maybe to add new features or whatnot. And that means that we spend a lot of time reading. So we want your code to be easy to understand, easy to read. The other thing is that we want you to follow good practices. What are good practices? Well, any .NET developer should know about SOLID. Any object-oriented developer should know about SOLID principles. What are the SOLID principles? That's kind of a tech question that we actually ask, just to make sure that people know that. But in the job ad, we say normally you live and breathe SOLID. Okay. So hopefully you know that by now. And if don't, just go Google it. It's everywhere. I'm sure that you can memorize it and just pass that. You know, it's super easy. But we want to see that. We want to see that you did something that shows SOLID. Now, because this is a tech test and it's just a practice thing, we don't expect you to build something over-engineered either.
Okay.
We just want to show... want you to show that you know about it. Sometimes it's okay if you don't do it and you write on the README file saying, I could have done this, but it would have been over-engineered, and you explain why you wanted to do it and what it is, and then we know how this person knows about this. Another thing that we check is that there is unit test. Because for us, something that is kind of production ready or something that shows that you how you work is something that has unit tests. We don't like shipping code that cannot be tested, that cannot be debugged, that doesn't have coverage. We want to know that everything that we're shipping has some level of coverage. Now, that doesn't mean unit test all the things that you write, but unit test the main units of work that you are creating there, that where the logic lives. That's what you need to unit test.
Okay.
So those are kind of things that we looked into. We looked at it's easy to read. We looked at you're following normal patterns of object-oriented programming. We looked at you're using the relevant technologies. So if you're applying for a full-stack .NET developer role, please don't submit a PHP application, right? Because of course I can see through PHP.
That's happened?
Yes, it does. We can see that you know. You might follow all of the things. You might do object-oriented, dependency injection, all of that. And I know that you know it, but do you really
Why
know
C-sharp? Why didn't you do it with
C-sharp? Now, here's the thing, though. If you're applying for a C-sharp role, a .NET role, and you submit your application in Java, I'm okay with that. And the reason for that is that they are pretty similar, right? So I understand that if you know all of the things about Java, maybe you're not a .NET developer, but I know that it's easy for you to pick up .NET being a Java developer than it is from a PHP developer or for a Python developer to pick up .NET, because they are quite different, those others. Now, after the tech test arrived and we evaluate it, like I said, we do, and we like it or not. And actually, in all honesty, the evaluation can take longer. And the reason for that is that
who do the evaluation?
That we have a trainee do okay. the evaluation.
Okay.
And so it's not only me. I would normally look into it, but in all honesty, lately I haven't had the time to look. So we delegated just to our senior developers.
Okay.
And they tend to look into it. We'll have three or four people look into it and all give their feedback, things that are pros and cons, I guess. And then once we have that, the development manager, the person that's hiring, sorry, will decide, yes, we like this person, let's invite them over. And what we do on that interview, it's we first ask the standard technical questions. You know, I'm sure you can find a GitHub list of technical questions for .NET or for whatever. So we do those standard things just to make sure that you know the basis. We want to cover those bases. And after that, we go over the technical test and we ask you to explain to us, what is it that you've done? Why do you do it that way? What would you do differently if you had more time? And then we try to see if we can poke holes at it, try to see if we can ask you to change something and actually see you, how you process that, how do you change it.
Okay.
So we want you to code a bit. Sometimes people won't code. People would like to just grab one of our whiteboards and draw their the diagram of how they would do it different or how the logic was or what other algorithm they might use, and that's perfectly fine. But we just want to make sure that you that we understand how is it that you're going to be doing your job day to day, right? How do you think, approach things? And how do you feel under the pressure of being in an interview and having someone ask you to change something, right? Because sometimes you will get that kind of pressure when we have deadlines and that kind of things on the day-to-do job. So I guess asking someone during the interview to change something kind of simulates a bit of that working under stress sort of situation.
Yeah.
So after that happens, we'll send the candidate away and then we'll get together the people who are interviewing, and normally it'd be two or three developers or maybe two developers and the hiring manager. Not necessarily the hiring manager is not necessarily going to be in that interview, but they might be, and they'll get together and they'll give feedback about how they thought the candidate performed under that. Now we do understand that it's a high pressure interview, so we take that into consideration that people can get nervous, but what we really want is to first see that you actually have the skills that you said you had on your CV and that the tech test wasn't done by someone else. We want to see how you behave under pressure. We want to see if you are flexible with change when we ask you to change. But we also want to see if you can communicate the things that you've done, that you can explain it to someone else. Because in every role, a trade me that we have, we expect our developers to be people that are building up other people as well. So if you're an intermediate developer, we hope that you have junior developers that you are mentoring and helping them grow in their career. If you're a senior developer, we expect you to help the intermediate developers keep growing. If you're a junior developer, we have interns every year that we hope that you are helping grow as well. One of the things that I forgot to say is that through the tech interview, also through the first interview, we give them time to the candidates to ask us questions, because I'm hoping you want to know about the place that you want to work for, you want to know more about TradeMe. So in the first one, you might ask questions about the culture, right? And that's perfectly fine. We want to hear what are your questions about. And in the second one, you might want to ask about a stack. You're applying for a full stack development or any role that you're applying, and you probably need to know what tools you'll be using and the state of the stack and what a maybe things that we should improve and that kind of things. As a candidate, it's something that you will face on the first day, and you should probably already know if you want to work in there. Because let's say that we had all legacy code and you never ask anything, but you hate legacy code, and then you join us, and even though we're hiring for a full stack developer and you're doing full stack and you're only stuck doing legacy code, then you're not going to have a good time and you might leave, and that's something that's not good for us either. So we want people that take that initiative also to ask questions.
Okay, makes sense.
And do your homework, I guess, right? Be prepared. Okay, try to understand, is TradeMe a .NET house or is it a Java house? Is it what is it that they do, that kind of stuff?
Yeah.
And even if you don't find those answers, you can just ask them. I tried to find, but I couldn't. What is your stack? Are you in the cloud? Are you on data centers? Do you use this pattern, this other, yeah.
Yeah.